Corrupt Canadian Elections, Vote Fixing, written and witnessed by Daniel J. Towsey, updated April 30th, 2012. Notice, please read my other article that provides much more information on this issue at Danielle Towsey WordPress site. Entitled, Once Upon a Time There Was a Canada. Let it be known to all. I wrote this document entitled Remedy for Our Stolen Democracy in hopes that you'll realize that this is information which all free Canadians need to know to ensure the protection of our democracy. This statement has previously been released to all members of our parliament. This has been read by many people online at the internet's World Wide Web, at public forums, online news medias, and more. Remedy for Our Stolen Democracy, dear citizens, please read this. Originally written 2001 and revised after June 30, 2002, we in Canada have a very serious problem with corruption in our voting process. It has been going on since approximately 1969. Since the use of computers, I witnessed this as a result of working on a federal election campaign. We have a very old voting system that is extremely flawed. First, it has to be understood how a voting station, polling station, works. Polling stations are manned by public volunteers from all represented parties. All activities and ballot counting is witnessed by them in the polling stations. When the polling station closes, the witnesses manually count all ballots for retrieving. Then the results are reported by telephone to an undisclosed location and local campaign headquarters, at which time the someone sitting at a computer terminal can enter any vote results he or she feels like entering, as there are no witnesses present for this process. In Canada, there is no way to verify those computer results, as all ballots are blank. The ballots are useless once the witnesses leave the polling stations. There is no way to verify the accuracy of the information that is entered in the computer bank. We have no safeguards against the corruption of vote results. Most corruption will occur in highly populated areas, since these activities will likely not be noticed. Another thing to realize is that while the votes are being counted, no one knows what the vote counter results are at the other polling stations in the riding, and in this way if the results reported on the television are wrong, none of the witnesses will be aware of it. Realize that each riding has many polling stations, so none of the witnesses really knows what the total vote count is for the riding. This makes it very easy to corrupt the vote count. Only the campaign headquarters knows the vote tally. Please understand that once the witnesses take their eyes off the ballot box and leave the polling station, the votes mean nothing. The witness should be given a document signed by every witness indicating the vote count at that polling station. Also, the vote counts for each polling station should be available online after the election so they can be verified and scrutinized by the witnesses to make sure there is no discrepancies or errors. This is not the case, and that omission proves that that is deliberately so. And as I discovered when the fraud happens, there is no remedy for it. Who would believe it? It is to be understood that if even the smallest possibility for vote corruption exists, then all possible safeguards should be put in place for the witnesses to eliminate it. I suggest that we put into place a system where all ballots have a unique UPC barcode on the backside. Then each polling station would be allotted a predetermined number of ballots. The location of each and every ballot would be accounted for through the whole voting process. The ballots would randomly and anonymously be given out to voters at each polling station. At the end of the day, the used and unused ballots could be counted manually as well as with a computerized counting machine, scanned with computer. All activities need to be monitored by the volunteer, public, witnesses. The ballots will still need to be counted manually. In this way, all ballots will be accounted for in the whole country. To further safeguard, I repeat, each and every volunteer will be given a printed signed copy of the results to keep before they leave the polling station, so that results can be collaborated in the future by the volunteers at an online site or manually through public records. There should also be any other security safeguards put in place to ensure that the possibility for corruption never exists again. Note, the chief reporting electoral officer should have no authority to do any certifying of vote results without public witnesses from the represented parties being present to witness all his certification activities, our votes need to be protected. Our democracy starts at the polling stations on the day we vote. Let's make sure it does not stop there. I am a proud and free Canadian. Sincerely, Mr. Daniel J. Towsey. All truth passes through three stages. First, it is ridiculed. Second, it is violently opposed, attacked. Third, it is accepted as self-evident. Arthur Schopenhauer, philosopher 1788 to 1860.